Hi, my name is Linda Hotchkiss. I'm from Long Island, New York. I've been tying flies for about 10 years, and I specialize in woven trout flies. These are flies that can be fished mostly as nymphs. I do stone flies, caddis, which we'll be tying today, but also woven flies, spiders, spinner flies, and some other specialty flies that are done with weaving techniques. Materials are very simple. I'm going to use a Daiichi hook, 1150, and it's going to be a size 8. I'll also have a 7/8 bead on there. I'm also going to use DMC cotton embroidery floss or embroidery thread. This is a material you can get at Michael's or any craft store. Comes in a variety of colors, and you can choose colors that match your river. I do these flies in greens, browns, and today we're going to be doing a salmon pink. When you get the embroidery floss, it comes, there are 6 strands. Normally what I do is I break away and use 3 strands, depending on the size of the hook. So I'm going to use 2 colors today, white and a salmon pink, and that is going to be used white on the bottom and the salmon on top, and we're going to go ahead and tie in the fly. Okay, weaving a fly is an old-fashioned technique, comes in and out of popularity. The first thing I'm going to do is mount the thread, the embroidery floss, onto the thing. The lighter color, the color I want to be on the bottom, is going to be on the far side of the hook. Just bring that down just about to the bend. The material keeper, I'm going to take the other one. And this head area is going to be covered with some dubbing, so while it can be neat, it doesn't have to be perfect. And I'm just going to go down the other side of the hook closer to me with the other color of the weaving. Now, because I'm going to be going back and forth in front of the hook, I want to bring and tie off my thread so that I can move the vise and not have it in the way. When I do that, I'm going to make sure as I take my thread off that I leave it long coming out of the bobbin, because I'm going to use it and grab it with one hand. And if you have a little extra thread hanging out, it makes it easier for you to remount the bobbin onto the fly. Okay. The weaving pattern I'm going to do is called a shuttle weave or a parallel weave. Important parts of it is to hold your thread firmly with even tension and to bring it at right angles away from the hook. And it's kind of a three-dimensional kind of weave. So I'm going to go under, and then I'm going to go over and come back and forth, catching it so that the white color is on the bottom, the pink's on the top, and the seam, if my pressure is and tension is even, the seam of the fly should go right along there. And now once I start this, I'm kind of committed to going all the way up the fly. As you go, you can, going back and forth, you can also use an overhand knot, which will produce a very similar type of weave. And as I get up to here, I'm going to stop, and this is where I'm going to grab the thread again and bring the bobbin back on to the hook. Okay, reposition the vise back in front of me. I'm going to bring my bobbin up, catch the thread on, and then just tie off the embroidery floss and clip it as close to behind the bead as I can. Okay. One or two extra turns just to keep yourself there. And next I'm going to choose to put some dubbing on. You can use ice dub, a little flat, something with a little sparkle in it, or you can use hare's ear, which is a traditional Polish woven nymph dubbing. The other thing you can add to this is a wire, which you would tie in. Of course, when you tied your threads, your embroidery floss in, when you get done at this point, you would then weave the wire back through, placing it right between the knots to give you some extra reinforcement and show some ribbing. Tie a bit of dubbing on, doesn't have to be a lot. And this is hare's ear. Bring it up right behind this looks very buggy. And then finish the fly right behind there. Clip this off, and then you can also, if you want to, just give it a bit of a haircut. Take care of some of those extra threads that are in. It's a Polish woven nymph. It's got a tungsten bead on it. It's going to sink right to the bottom. It's great on the bottom of a nymph rig. If you're fishing multiple nymphs, and it'll work good as an anchor point nymph for check nymphing.